Hi, welcome to QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB tutorial number 26. This tutorial is the continuation of tutorial number 25, which is strongly recommended that you start with before you go through this tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be solving a stationary Inviscid Compressible flow past a bump in two dimensions, but we will be using adaptive mesh refine features, AMR. So, most of the code has been already discussed in the previous tutorial. Just repeat the mesh. Yeah, again, that's the bump. Here we have slip walls, slip walls, slip walls, slip walls, inlet and outlet. We set reference values, initialize the solution, set convergence criteria, current number, and so on. And now we move to the main iterative loop. The crucial difference between this and previous code is the mesh adaptation technique, which will result in better convergence and finer resolution of the shockwaves that we're gonna capture in this simulation. We will be refining our mesh during the course of our simulation in a few design steps. They are shown in these brackets. We will be calling the function AMR with specific objective function that's called weighted pressure jump. This function serves as a criterion for our mesh refinement. During the course of simulation, we'll also display the mesh. You also need to remember about clearing imposed CFD boundary conditions to D because they are necessary to be set up from the scratch as the function AMR modifies the mesh. Other things are exactly as in previous tutorial. So we assemble the Euler problem to D matrix, we impose those boundary conditions, that means far field as the inlet, compressible outlet at the outlet, and slip walls on top and bottom, solve the system of equations, check the residuals, and also display pressure field and Mach number field every 5 steps. Okay, so without any further ado, let's run the simulation. There goes our pressure field. Now you can observe how the mesh changes. Yeah, first stronger shocks start to appear and the mesh gets finer at those points. Let's have a look in more detail in the next mesh update. Once again, we can see the results here. Let's just have the closer view. Yeah, two shocks being captured here and here. Okay, the rest of the simulation will go on fast forward in this video without any comments, but you can already see that the pressure field and Mach number field are of much better quality than in tutorial 25. Adaptive mesh refinement techniques are absolutely necessary for compressible flow simulations for Mach number. Okay, the solution has converged in 129 time steps. Took a while. Anyway, let's have a look at the results. Yeah, the mesh is really fine in the places where the shocks appear. I can see how many elements are here. Okay. Let's look at the simulation results. Okay, yeah, you can see the shock waves gently forming. Mach number drops. Obviously, the flow is everywhere supersonic because, like, there's the tangential component of velocity along the shock wave. Just mind that. Obviously, Mach number abruptly drops. Yeah, so that's all. We hope that you enjoyed this simulation. We recommend that you visit our website and check out other models for CFD.